Equality California has played a critical leadership role in moving our community forward for years around employment discrimination, relationship recognition, protecting our LGBT students in our school systems. Every time there's been a major issue or challenge confronting our community, Equality California has been there.
It's an extraordinary thing, 100 plus legislative victories.
We gathered together at those early meetings in about the year 2000. We had a mission and a purpose. We wanted marriage. We didn't know how we were going to get there. We didn't know how it was going to happen. And we have now done that. And so the question is, okay, so now what do we do in a post-marriage equality California? I think that Equality California is perfectly positioned to do what the Anti-Defamation League does, what the NAACP does. They make sure that they not only fight for their own people, but for a just California. For a California that's about equality for all.
Equality California is now thinking of itself as the statewide civil rights organization for California's LGBT community.
That means if it's important to our community, it's important to Equality California.
The first component of our mission is to assure full equality for LGBT people, no matter where they are.
It's important that equality extends to those outside of California. I mean, we're not stationary beings.
The minute we step outside of the state and the protections that it affords, our families, our relationships are vulnerable. We want to ensure that every state in this country, and indeed the entire world, is a place where LGBT people have full equality.
Equality California has one of the largest mobilization and outreach capabilities of any LGBT organization in the country.
Over 800,000 people on our outreach list.
It can really activate the community at a moment's notice.
We intend to use our mobilization capabilities to advance LGBT rights nationwide.
As a gay man, I was not able to give blood when members of my family were going into surgery. This is not just about discrimination, but it has real impacts on our ability to protect and care for our own families.
And AJR 50 is a resolution that asks the Food and Drug Administration to modernize its policies with respect to gay men giving blood.
One of our sponsor bills this year, AB 2501, would make us the first state to ban the panic defense, which is a really outrageous tactic used in criminal trials to reduce the sentence of someone who has murdered a person who is gay, lesbian, bisexual, or transgender.
Equality California recognizes that legal protections alone cannot ensure full and lasting equality for our community.
LGBT people continue to suffer from disproportionate rates of homelessness, violence, uninsurance, and poverty.
Through generous grants from the California Endowment, our program Health Happens for Equality has enrolled thousands of LGBT Californians under the Affordable Care Act.
We have a large community of transgender Latinas, for example, who are very high risk for HIV because they face homelessness, they're undocumented, they face so many obstacles here.
The goal of Fair Share for Equality is to ensure that the numbers in our community are actually reflected in the resources that are allocated. If we are not counted, we don't count.
One of the new programs that I'm excited about is our new expanded political program.
Serving in local government is definitely part of the step to state leadership or federal leadership in terms of running for Congress or Senate.
Helping fill statewide offices with openly LGBT people sends a message to youth that it's okay to be gay. It's okay to be from the LGBT community. You can have role models in statewide office.
Under our new mission statement, Equality California is dedicated to assuring a fair and just California for every community.
Our members come from every single part of our society, every single ethnic group, every single religious group. Because of that, it's important for us to think about issues that perhaps on the surface are not seen as LGBTQ issues, when in reality they are. Immigration reform is an LGBT rights issue because it is a human rights issue.
I grew up in a rural Latino farm community south of Albuquerque, New Mexico. It was a place where LGBT kids could not come out and a place where those who were suspected were subject to ostracism and bullying. We have places like that right here in California today, and that is why Equality California is focused on making sure that kids in the Central Valley, in parts of Orange County, wherever they grow up, have the same opportunities that everyone else does.
What do we want? Safe school! What do we want it now? What do we want?
As an elected official, I know how important it is to have the Equality California endorsement because I know they only endorse candidates that are 100% on LGBT issues.
You can't be 99%, you can't be 98%. Somebody who stands with Equality California stands 100% behind them and is not only involved in their issues, but is committed to their issues.
If it weren't for Equality California putting pressure on people in positions of formal authority, we would never have gotten as far as we have gotten over the last 10 years.
As a straight ally, Equality California is extremely important to me because I want to live in a state and a country where everyone has civil rights.
That fundamental universal principle of equality. We're all better off when we're all better off.
The work is far from done, but it likely will change its course and its nature in the years to come.
We're not just about marriage. We're about meeting the needs of California's LGBT community, not as a social service organization, but by using our political skill, our legislative skill, and our outreach and mobilization capacity to achieve full equality.